Hey, Monty, do you do me a favour?
Depends what it is.
Well, I've been thinking about what you and B said about the money, you know, about having to hide it real good.
Yeah?
My old man's a real demon, you know, he can smell money a mile off.
So?
So, I don't reckon I've hit it too good.
What do you want me to do about it?
You'll be getting out of here soon, won't you? Well, if I give you a piece of the action, do you reckon you could move it to a safer spot for me?
Talk to me sometime.
All right, Anderson, come on up you get. No point lying there on your own.
Go jump.
That'll do, Doreen.
You're in enough trouble, Anderson, without adding insubordination to the list.
The governor wants to see you after breakfast.
What about?
Oh, I'm sure you know.
I just hope you get what's coming to you.
Come on, Doreen. Hurry up and get dressed.
Lenny. Look, stop calling me that. I lost my work release because of you, and Lizzie took the blame for something she didn't even do. So you weren't even big enough to own up to it, so just leave me alone.
Come on, Lenny. Dore didn't make me do it, so let's forget the whole thing, eh?
I won't forget it.
Mrs. Davidson says she won't stop your parole, and that's the main thing, isn't it?
She better not.
A bit hard on Doreen, weren't you?
What'd you expect?
What are you trying to do? Free set of ourselves.
Now, stop complaining, Smith. You're lucky you've even got heating.
You call this heating? It's all right for you, lot. You can go home to warm beds.
Yeah, and it doesn't matter whose.
You're just out of condition, Smith.
How would you know, Fletch?
Maybe Mrs. Jackson could talk to Dr. Miller about keeping us in condition.
Ooh, what's got into you? But you don't care about him anymore.
I don't
care. Well, just because your fancy lawyer friend's giving you the brush, no need to make everyone else's life a misery.
Since when did you start caring about a screw's feelings?
Since I found out that some of them have got a few more than some of the idiots in here.
Good morning.
Oh, belt up, Monty.
What do I do?
Graph.
Oh, good morning, Monty. Yeah, thanks. I thought it was too.
Hey, Monty.
Oh, God, what do you want?
Did you sleep on it?
I slept on it.
And?
Find yourself another mug. Look, all I want to do is get back with Fred. I'm not doing nothing that's going to land me back in here.
Oh, but think of the loot. Look, name your price and it's yours. Within reason.
Don't need it.
Oh, but it's easy money. Come on, use your head, will you?
She wouldn't know how.
And I always thought you did your trumpeting behind people's backs.
Being a hunk of blubber, I thought you'd want to know. I'm not giving any more handouts to save the whale.
Go and run before I sit on you and squash you!
Oh, come on, Monty, think about it a bit more.
I'll bag it, will you?
Oh, damn.
She tried to stop another girl's parole, Mrs. Davidson. Surely that calls for disciplinary action.
I intend to take action, Mr. Fletcher, but I shall listen to what she has to say first.
If we don't make an example of her, other girls will be doing the same thing.
As I recall, you wanted to make an example of Lynn Warner.
Yes, well, that was an understandable mistake.
Yes. In future, I shall trust my own knowledge of these women rather than taking the advice of someone who has only been here 2 minutes. Come in. I have been told that you were the one who planted the letters and tablets in Lynn Warner's things. Is that true, Doreen?
Yeah.
Why? Had she done something to upset you?
Lynn's a friend of Doreen's.
I see. It was a stupid and very cruel thing to do.
Yeah, I know.
I'm moving you back to the laundry. Lynn can work in the garden until her parole. It won't hurt for you both to be separated for a while.
I suggest we move one of them to another dormitory as well.
No! I mean, I didn't mean to hurt her.
I think Doreen's learned a lesson.
All right. You can go, Doreen.
you call that discipline?
There is such a thing as too much discipline.
This sort of sick behaviour has got to be stopped.
What do you suggest we do? We can't put every woman in a single cell.
Besides, Lynn will be paroled soon. There's no point in disrupting the rest of the women for such a short period.
Very well. But it's something we should watch in future. Now, the women have got far too much time on their hands. That's why they play these stupid games.
If you have a solution to the problem, I shall be only too happy to hear it.
Well, there's another matter I'd like to discuss with you. Joyce Martin. The police still haven't recovered the money from that robbery.
And?
Well, I'd like to ask her a few more questions.
I was here when you questioned her before. I will not have the women coerced into any rash statements under pressure, Mr. Fletcher. This is not a police department, but if anything positive comes to my attention, I will make sure the right authorities are advised. Thank you, Mr. Fletcher, Mrs. Jackson.
Yeah, you too.
Sure.
Oh, Lynn, have you heard about your parole?
Well, they said it could come through today.
Oh, that's great. You'll get it.
Oh, after all the trouble Doreen's got me into.
Well, at least they know it wasn't your fault.
I couldn't stand it if they turned me down, Karen.
I know. Look, don't be too hard on Doreen. I can't talk. I wasn't very good with Frankie, but she didn't mean it. She didn't set out deliberately to hurt you. I better go.
I thought they would have put you in solitary.
I'm not allowed to work in the garden with you anymore.
Good.
Oh, but you've got to listen to me, Lynn. I missed you, that's all. I got lonely. I know what I'd done to you was rotten, but don't hate me. Lynn? Oh, don't look at me like that, please.
You touch me again, I'll report you.
You're my friend.
I wouldn't be friends with you if we were the only two in here.
You got a sec?
Oh, what do you want this time?
Your eyes are better than mine. How about threading that for me, huh?
Struth, you are bloody useless.
Look, there's no way you'll get caught. All you got to do is move it from one place to another. We're the only ones who'll know.
You never let up, do
you? Oh, what were you going, will you?
Hey, what'd you say?
What do you think I'm doing back here?
Oh, there's no need to snap me head off. I only asked.
Yeah, well, if you used your head for once, you wouldn't have to ask such dumb questions.
Yeah, if you didn't do such dumb things, we wouldn't have to ask any questions. Look, you got no one to blame but Al, but yourself. So put it down to experience and dry up.
Pity you don't follow your own advice, Smith.
I got some advice for you too, Vera. You want to hear it?
I think we've all heard what little you have to say about 1,000 times.
Oh, she's sharp this morning, girls. The new deputy governor keeping you on your toes, is he, Vera?
You're wanting the governor's office, Ferguson.
Oh, good. What am I supposed to have done this time? Hey, maybe she's heard about my parole.
You'll find out soon enough. But if it was up to me, I wouldn't let people like you out on the street.
That's because you can't live without me, Vera.
Get going. Good luck.
Break an arm, faggy!
It's a leg, stupid.
Oh, won't seem the same without money.
There.
You will be released at 2 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. You've hardly been a model prisoner. I shan't be sorry to see you go.
Yeah, that goes for me too.
I can only hope you will do better on the outside.
Oh, you've got to be kidding. I never want to see another screw again as long as I live. And I mean see, not have.
You've got a filthy mouth, Ferguson.
It's all in your mind, Miss Bennett.
That's enough. Now get out. Charming.
Well, that one won't stay out of trouble for too long.
You'd better bring Lynn Warner in, please, Miss Bennett.
Warner?
The board has approved your parole, Lynn. You will be released tomorrow afternoon.
That's fantastic.
If you like, I'll see that your parents are told.
Oh, thank you.
You will have to report to the parole board for the next 3 months, but you can do that from home. You were sent back here once. I trust there won't be a next time. It's not going to be easy, but that's up to you. You're young. You have your whole life ahead of you. Don't throw it away.
No, Mrs. Davidson.
That's all, Lynn.
Thank you.
Oh, before you go, Miss Bennett, how do you think Mr. Fletcher is getting along?
I still think it was a mistake sending a man like that to do a job like this.
In what way?
He's got no idea how to handle the women.
You seem quite pleased with the way he handled Joyce Martin.
I'm not questioning his ideas on discipline, just his attitude.
Well, I'm a little more concerned about his ideas. I don't want any unnecessary badgering or bullying.
I'll keep an eye on him.
I wasn't suggesting we should spy on him, Miss Bennett. If we continue to show him how we do things here, perhaps he will come around to our way of thinking.
You could be right, Mrs. Davidson.
Wait till I get my hands on him. Ruff! Watch out, friend!
Yeah, I wouldn't put my hands on him too heavily if I were you, otherwise you'd be up for assault again.
Oh, good, that's the furthest thing from me mind. Silence, I don't fear a grudge here, but Fred might. Fred was never one to bear a grudge either.
You better let him know you're getting out.
No, why? I wouldn't miss seeing the look on his face for quids.
Yeah, but it might be the other way round. Huh? Well, you know what they say, when the cat's away.
Fred! You've got to be joking. Listen, I wouldn't trust him with money, but I sure as hell would with another woman. I mean, nobody would look twice at him.
Has he ever come to visit you?
So what? Perhaps he thinks I'm still crooking him. Put him in here. And I'll prove different once I'm out.
Guess what? My parole's come through. I'm getting out tomorrow.
Oh, good on you, love.
There you are. I told you the governor would come good today.
Maybe some more luck rubbed off on you, eh?
Yeah, well, I reckon it's our luck getting rid of two drongos at once. And the noisemaker and the rainmaker.
Thank you very much, Beatrice.
Anyway, we'll have a jam session tonight and celebrate.
You can't be trusted by yourselves for 5 minutes, can you? Now, come on, back to work, you. Back to the garden.
Oh, come on, Fletch. She's getting out tomorrow.
As long as she's in here, she'll do as she's told.
Boy, standing over little girls must make you feel real tough, eh, Fletch?
It's Mr. Fletcher to you, and if you don't start that press, I'll just find something else for you to do.
Oh, God, I've done me back in.
Excitement! The old ticker's gone and went on me again, Mr. Fletcher.
Oh, God, me head. Look, I've just got to see the doc and do something about it.
I've got to go to the loo.
Nobody is going anywhere.
Well, I reckon we've done about enough work for today, eh, girls?
All right, suit yourselves. You can do it tonight, then. No celebration.
You wouldn't believe this.
What?
This letter to Joyce Martin. I thought it was written by a child, but it's from her aunt. Oh, it's no wonder they end up the way they do.
Oh, really, Vera?
Meg, did Mrs. Davidson speak to you about Mr. Fletcher?
Mm-hmm.
She seems to be worried about him.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, come on, Meg, you know what I'm talking about. And you don't like him any more than I do.
Look, he doesn't upset me unduly.
No, he's got a chip on his shoulder a mile wide.
He may have problems.
Like what? What do you know about him?
Nothing. It's just a feeling, I guess. You may have family problems.
We've all been through those, but we don't bring them to work.
Just wait here, please. It's Mr. Ferguson. He wants to see his wife.
Monica Ferguson's husband. Well, it's not visiting hours.
But he says it's urgent.
Well, he'll just have to wait.
Well, I told him that, but he said it's the only time he's got to see her.
Look, it's her last day.
Excuse me. I've got to see my wife. It's a matter of life and death.
Oh, all right. I'll get her. Take over, Mrs. Jackson.
Thank you, madam. You're reading everybody's personal mail?
Look, I think you can take Mr. Ferguson to the interview room.
This way, please, Mr. Ferguson. Come along.
G'day, love.
Fred! Freddy, love, you great big liar!
Ferguson, you know the rules. No physical...
physical contact.
Oh, look, I was just telling the girls about how I was going to surprise you when I get out tomorrow. Well, you're going to ruin the surprise, but who cares? It's so good to see you. Gee, your face healed up real well. I thought I'd broken your nose this time, but you always did know how to roll with the punches. You know, I was just telling Bea Smith
love,
the other day.
Shut
about
up
how
for
you
2 seconds, will you?
Okay, lovey.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to need your help. I didn't want to bother you about anything, but...
Go on, Freddie. What's a wife for?
Well, after you got put in this place, well, I felt bloody rotten about the whole thing.
I haven't forgotten.
Yeah, well, I had to drown me sorrow, so I got mixed up with some bad company.
You're not in any trouble, are you, Fred?
Oh, it wouldn't have happened if you'd have been around. You know I can't help myself. I needed you, love. I run up some debts on the trots.
I should have known. So what? Money will be coming through for the shop soon. I'll fix them up and we'll forget all about it. How much are you in for?
$12,000.
What? You
stick! Please, you're coming!
Get back to that table or out you go, Ferguson.
You thieving little runt!
I should have you round when she gets out.
Well, any more outbursts and you'll have to leave.
Oh. I'm real sorry, Petal, but you weren't there.
Yeah, I bet that's not where all the money went. How much that suit you're wearing cost you?
Oh, I wanted to look good for you, sweetheart.
Yeah, well, I'm getting around in these. I've got a good mind to let you get out of this mess yourself.
Oh, but you don't know what this bloke's like. My life won't be worth two bob if I don't cough up. I've got to get the money to him in 2 days or he's going to do me in. Well, please. Petal.
Ah, come on, Dory. No point in moping about. Got any ideas for the party tonight?
No. How about you and me doing one of our little numbers, eh?
No, I don't want to.
Thank God for that.
Well, I'll knock his flaming block off.
Now, what's got into you?
You know who my visitor was? Fred. Good old Fred.
Jeez, Monty, you're with him 5 minutes and you want to pulverise him.
You know what he's gone and done? He's got himself into debt with some bookie for $12,000. It's up to me to get him off the hook.
You gonna do it?
Oh, I love him, don't I? God knows why. Anyway, I'll have a bit over when I sell the shop.
Yeah, but it won't leave you with much.
Been flat broke before.
Bloody men. You can't leave him alone for 10 minutes.
If you ladies can't work and talk at the same time, then I suggest you just work.
And tote that barge, lift that veil.
Bit of extra cash wouldn't hurt.
Well?
Okay, I'll move it for you. It's going to cost you plenty.
How'd you go, lover?
Are we going to celebrate tonight?
You mean she came through?
Yep. Just as well I saw her today. If I'd have waited till she got out, I'd be mincemeat. Phew. She hasn't changed a scrap. Phew. What a temper.
Some women just don't know how to treat a man.
We better play it cool tomorrow, Blossom. She's getting out.
So you get the money then?
Uh-huh. When I get my hands on it.
Be able to buy me another little present.
But I just got you this.
Well, you know I like my cars as hot as my men.
All right, I've given him the slip. The bastard's watching you like a hawk.
Yeah, we better be quick, though. We're due back at work in a minute.
I'm warning you, Monica. You try and run off with that money and I'll dob you into my husband's mate so fast, your life won't be worth living.
All I want for my trouble is 20 grand.
20 grand? Are you off your rocker?
Yeah, well, you got away with 150, didn't you? What's 20?
Thought you only needed 12.
20 or no deal.
Okay, but you better not cross me.
Where do I have to pick it up from?
It's at me Auntie Madge's.
You mean somebody else knows where it is?
Oh, don't worry about her. She's practically sent
well,
off.
Well, thanks, Joycey, but I'm packed by myself. There's not much here, really.
You're packing a bit early, aren't you, Ferguson?
Oh, well, you know how it is, Fletch. When you're having a holiday and having fun, you collect so much stuff.
Outside, Martin.
I'm on my lunch break.
Outside. You and Ferguson have got a lot to talk about?
Yeah, we've got a lot in common.
That's a pity she's getting out tomorrow. Or is that what you were talking about?
Beg yours?
Maybe you need her to check on that stolen money.
He's still on about that, eh? Look, if I had all that money, I wouldn't trust her as far as I could throw her, and that's not very far, is it, Mr. Fletcher?
All right, Ferguson, back to work.
I'd like a word with you, Martin. Alone. You and Mr. Fletcher seem to be getting on rather well.
So?
You knew him before, didn't you?
Not that I can remember.
Well, then you've got a bad memory. When you first arrived here, you said you did.
No, I said my husband, Harry, did. He was serving a bit of time in Pentridge when Fletch was a screw there.
Well, you also said that you'd heard something about him when he worked there. What was it?
No, Harry wouldn't like me to snitch on a friend, even if he is a screw. Excuse me, Miss Bennett. I've got to get back to work.
That doesn't sound like Karen.
Well, I didn't imagine it.
We're not saying you did. Look, some of the women are sending me up to, but I ignore it.
This wasn't just fun.
The moment they know they can get under your skin, the more they're going to try.
All right, I won't mention it again.
Well, I feel like telling the whole world.
The world seems to know already.
Why can't they issue us with regulation slippers instead of these great clodhoppers?
How's the head?
What?
Well, after the knock the other day, any headaches or side effects?
No, never felt better.
Come on, Lizzie. You're late.
All right, Miss Bennett. I've only got one pair of hands.
Joyce Martin tells me you and her husband are friends.
He was an inmate at Pentridge when I was there, that's all.
Here you are, Mr. Fletcher.
Thanks, Lizzie.
Miss Bennett.
At least that'd explain why you allowed him to visit Martin twice in one week.
What are you driving at?
We treat everyone equally here, Mr. Fletcher.
It was an honest mistake.
Oh, really? Martin doesn't seem to think so. Finish, Lizzie?
Oh, just going, Miss Jack.
Your honest mistake almost ended up in Martin being kidnapped. Seems like he's got something to hide.
Oh, give it a rest, Vera. You know nothing about him.
Do you?
Not much, but I think he's trying to do a good job.
Oh.
I've got to get back to work.
Yes, me too.
I reckon if he hadn't been such a gentleman, he would have clobbered Vera right there.
Hey, Joyce, can't you remember anything your old man said about him?
Oh, who listens to Harry? Were they real good friends?
No, I was just steering up Vera.
Yeah, well, I hope they kill each other.
You know, that's not a bad idea, Doreen. If we can keep Fletch and Vera at each other's throats, it'll keep them off our back.
That's a good one.
So, what's this then, a stop work meeting?
Yeah, we're thinking of upping our holidays to 5 weeks.
Back to work. Come on.
I want to see the governor.
What for?
I've got a sick friend and I want to send a telegram.
Well, you can see her later on this afternoon.
Hi.
Hi.
Feel like going out tonight?
No, all I feel like doing is having a stiff drink and putting my feet up.
Not one of your better days, eh?
I'm just sick of all the emotional undercurrents around here.
Now, who's it going to? And the message?
Get better real soon. Wish I could visit.
I haven't figured that out yet.
You haven't? Well, good. What have you been doing all this time?
Trying to talk you into moving it.
Decide what I'm moving it to. Pretty simple.
What are you doing with those boxes?
There for the party. The governor knows all about it.
On your way, Ferguson. You've been doing quite a bit of talking, Martin.
No law says I've got to take a vow of silence.
I've been shoved around too many times, Martin. This is a job I intend to keep. So if you think you've got anything on me, forget it. I'm not going to be pushed around by you or anybody else. So you just keep your big mouth shut.
Doreen? Party's about to start. Aren't you coming? You're really going to miss her, aren't you? Look, you've got to learn when to let go of someone, Doreen. Even if it hurts. And it will. Reacting the way, say Frankie did, that doesn't help anyone. It's the difference between loving somebody and being in love. The difference between a friendship and a relationship. Do you understand what I mean? Look, I wanted to be friends with Frankie, but she wanted more. She ended up with nothing. You can't force a person into loving you. Oh, I don't know, it's all so mixed up in here. You still want to be friends with Lynn, don't you? Well, then show her that's all you want.
She hates me.
I don't think so. Look, start by showing her that you can act like an adult. You're not a child anymore.
How do I do that?
What are you gawking at?
What are you supposed to be?
I didn't know it was fancy drink.
Oh, I reckon you look real lovely, Dawg.
Thanks, Lizzie.
Yeah, it makes you look 5 years older. Well, come on, you lot. It's supposed to be a party. Get a move on.
Yeah,
come on.
I'll teach you the latest steps, eh? Da 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 da
da da da da da da da da
da da
da
What are you going to do when you get home?
Oh, just work on the farm, I guess.
Would you mind if I wrote to you? I mean, to you?
If you like.
Would you like something to eat?
I'd love something.
Geez, you're useless, Doreen.
Oh, you did that on purpose.
Nah, must be the high heels you're wearing. You know, you ought to stick to your sand shoes, Doreen. More your style.
Oh, shut up!
Why do you pick on her like that?
You a mother? Or should I say, new lover?
You're revolting.
Want to make something of it?
No, but maybe I do.
Can't you take a joke, if it's funny? You don't think she's funny?
No, I don't.
Be made sure of that.
I can stand on my own two feet, you know.
I really liked your hair that way.
We'll never see each other again, will we?
Well, I'll be on the farm, but I'll think about you.
Will you stay with me tonight?
No, Doreen.
But it's the last night.
It'd only make things worse.
No, it wouldn't. I just want to be with you.
No!
I love you.
I'm going back to the party.
Right, it's time you took a bit of pride in yourself.
You're all out of condition. We're going to do something about it. From this morning, every morning, there'll be half an hour exercises.
Oh, what are you going to do tonight?
To begin with, we're going to run once around the garden. Lizzie, you can be excused if you want.
Oh, I could keep up with this lot.
Yeah, well, I can't.
Why not?
I got a bone in me leg.
That's the one ahead.
Right on the double, run!
Oh, anyone care to join me for a stroll around the garden?
Oh, don't mind if I do.
I said run!
This time of year.
Warner, I've got a message for you.
Yeah, I reckon we ought to hear this, girls.
Get back in line.
You don't mind if we listen to this, do you, Miss Bennett? After all, Lynn is one of the family.
This won't take a minute, Mr. Fletcher. Your father phoned. You're booked on the 4 o'clock bus. He'll pick you up at the other end.
Oh, terrific.
Wonderful. Now get inside and pack.
You lot are going to do these exercises if it takes all day.
Oh, what a shame. And I've gone and twisted my ankle.
You're not fooling anyone, Smith.
Oh, geez, Miss Bennett, you can see she's in pain.
We don't stop the women seeing the doctor if they've got a legitimate complaint, Mr. Fletcher. Regulations.
And do you think this is legitimate?
Oh!
Take her to see Dr. Miller.
Oh!
You're up.
I got to see him too.
And what's the matter with you, Birdsworth?
Women's complaints.
Get moving, Birdsworth.
Oh, you're a real understanding woman, Miss Bennett.
I have to get ready for university, Miss Bennett.
All right, Travers.
Well, what about us? Why should the rest of us be the only ones stuck out here?
Go on, get out of my sight. I would have given you more credit, Miss Bennett. You don't make a fool of me as easily as that.
I don't think you need any of my help, Mr. Fletcher.
If it's their respect you're after, you won't win it that way.
Respect is something I don't have to worry about.
Yes, well, don't try and undermine my authority too often, Miss Bennett.
I think you'll find I was acting by the book, Mr. Fletcher.
Can I come in?
Oh, sure. Well, I guess you'll be gone by the time I get back.
Oh, I guess I will. Remember the first day we got in here? I don't think I stopped crying once. Good luck.
She'll be back. She hasn't got what it takes.
I think she has. She'll make it.
All we have to do is add a bit of fuel to the fire and sit back and watch those two burn each other up.
Or we cop it if they ever start a green.
Oh, no need to worry about that. Vera's too keen on getting her old job back.
What's the safest place you can think of to hide stolen money?
Are you going to tell me, or do we have to play 20 quid?
Can't a person have a private conversation without you hanging around big ears?
Who wants to hear what you're going to say anyhow?
A bank, right?
What?
All you've got to do is open a safety deposit account in my name. Just make sure you get the key back to me.
Oh, and how am I supposed to do that?
Oh, come on, if you can't figure out a way to smuggle in one lousy little key.
Martha, there's a visitor for you. Why isn't Doreen Anderson here?
She wasn't feeling too good. Went to see the doc.
I reckon it was all them exercises she did this morning.
From what I hear, you didn't exactly strain yourselves. Keep an eye on Doreen, will you please, Ben?
Sure. Maybe I better go and check on her.
Oh, she'll be okay. You know, Dore, she always bounces back.
By the way,
Your friend got the telegram. It made her day.
She's getting out of hospital 2 o'clock this afternoon.
So quick.
Didn't know myself until the last minute.
Is anyone picking her up?
I don't know.
Well, we'll see what we can do.
Do you know Monica Ferguson?
Monica Ferguson? No.
Oh, well, doesn't matter. Just that I thought she said she knew you, that's all.
Well, before I forget, we've got your birthday present. But we'll keep it till you get out, if you like.
No worries.
Told some woman called Monica Ferguson. Ferguson gets out today, 2 o'clock on the dot.
What if someone meets her?
Jesus, then you'll just have to follow her until you can get her by herself.
What if she doesn't cough up?
We'll just have to make her, won't we?
No rough stuff unless you have to, Vinnie.
No Sheila's gonna stop me getting the money.
Oh, God. I hope he's at home.
Well, you should have arranged for him to meet you when he was here yesterday.
That's the whole point. I don't want him to meet me. Oh, come on, come on. Hello, Fred. What do you mean, who is it? It's Monty, a little twerp. Here, well, we're allowed to make this call on the last day in case we need to arrange a lift or anything, but that's what I want to talk to you about, love. There's no need for you to pick me up. But you don't need to, Fred. I said you don't bloody have to. Oh, look, sweetie, it's just so I want to get you a little prezzy. No, Fred, I'm not going to tell you. It's
can
a
I
surprise.
Help you?
Yes, I'd like to see my husband, Jim Fletcher. Is
no,
that possible?
Fred, I'm oh,
yes, of course, I'll get him for you straight away.
You could you tell him it's important? I have to see him.
Okay?
Yes, I will. Would you like
getting
to take a seat?
To seeing you, Fred. Oh, hang on, I've got to go, Fred. Bye. Oh, you screws are all alike. Oh, it's the last time.
That's enough.
When you're finished, report to reception. I'll check your cell to make sure everything's in order.
Look, I'll hardly be walking off with a keepsake.
Oh, Mr. Fletcher. Your wife is down at reception. She'd like to speak to you.
I haven't got time.
Oh, well, I can take over.
Tell her I'll ring her tomorrow.
Well, she said it was important.
Mrs. Jackson, I don't want to see my wife while I'm working. What the hell are you doing in there, Anderson? You've got 2 seconds to get back to work.
I'm staying here.
You can go quietly or take the consequences.
Oh, yeah? Come on, you just try it. You lay a finger on me and I'll kick your bloody head in.
Doreen, stop it. Now, what's going on?
I want this girl in solitary now.
What's she done?
She's meant to be working and she refuses to do as she's been told.
I gave her permission to stay here.
You what?
She wasn't feeling well, so I excused her from work.
All right. But there better not be a next time, Anderson.
Thanks, Mrs. Jackson. He's a pig.
That's quite enough out of you. Don't ever expect me to do that again. And the next time an officer tells you to do something, you will do it. And if I ever hear you swearing at an officer again, I'll be the one to put you in solitary. Now, is that clear?
Yes, Mrs. Jackson.
You've got 5 minutes.
Acting tough's not going to change anything, Doreen.
It was his fault. He's out to get me.
Just stay out of his way.
Oh, who cares?
You hate solitary, you know that. Look, you've still got Bea, Lizzie and Karen. You'll soon forget about me. I thought I had another rib. Oh, doesn't matter, I didn't want it anyway. I'll write as often as I can, I promise.
Well, you'll forget about me as soon as you get back to your mum and dad.
No, I won't. I can hardly wait to see them. You'd really like Mum. I wish you could meet her. Just think, tomorrow night, a home-cooked meal, my very own room. I can hardly believe it.
Well, you can stick your stupid room.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Fletcher. Your husband's very busy at the moment. He said he'd ring you at home.
Didn't you tell him it was important?
Yes, I did.
He didn't want to see me, right?
Excuse me, I've got to...
I've been trying to ring Jim for the past couple of days and every time he hears it's me, he hangs up. I just got to get through to him.
Well, I'm sorry, Mrs. Fletcher, I can't help.
Look, I know I'm putting you in an embarrassing situation, and I'm sorry, but could you at least pass a message on for me?
Look, why don't you write to him? I just don't think that I should get involved.
Oh, if I wrote, he'd only tear it up. Please, I'm only trying to protect the family.
You know, Miss Bennett, I reckon it's real nice of you to let us say goodbye to those two, especially after Fletcher turned us down. You ought to tell him to loosen up a bit.
Well, Mr. Fletcher hasn't been here long enough.
You sure you won't get into trouble with him, Miss Bennett?
I think I know more about Wentworth than he does.
It's good to know who's still boss around here.
Just hurry it along.
Okay. Righty-o, you lot, I want to say a couple of words. Shut up. First off, I think we should say thanks to Miss Bennett for letting us see off our mates. Okay. All right, now, Monty, I know we've had our ups and downs.
Oh, look, I'm big enough not to hold it against you, B.
Yeah, well, I reckon we're all going to miss seeing you around. Mainly because it's very hard to miss seeing you at all. But look, I've got one thing to say to you and one thing only. Next time you want to bash Fred up, for goodness sake, kiss and make up afterwards so he doesn't press charges, will you? And Lenny, well, I reckon we've straightened you out enough for you to behave yourself from now on. But a bit of advice. Go home and stay home. Wouldn't you know it? She's crying.
No, I'm just happy.
Come on, Smith, that's enough time.
Oh, look after yourself, you old dear.
Oh, you break me ribs, you big buffoon.
Keep them low, Beth.
It's all right.
Good luck, Molly.
No worries.
Have you seen Doreen?
I reckon she's getting it out of her system, love.
Say goodbye to her for me and take care of her.
Of course I will. Don't you worry. She'll be all right. Just make sure you never come back here, right?
I've been looking for you.
I felt like a break. Is my wife gone?
Uh-huh.
Good.
It's none of my business, but I think you should go to see her.
Oh, you do you?
Look, your personal life doesn't interest me, Mr. Fletcher, but I told your wife I'd give you a message.
Go on.
Well, it was the other night, the night I think you went out with Greg. She said you went to her house. You'd had a little to drink that
Yes, I was drunk. I was raving drunk, Mrs. Jackson. Is that what she told you? And I wanted to see my kids.
She said she doesn't want them to see you like that. It was after one in the morning.
They're my kids. I've got a right to see them whenever I want to.
She said if it happens again, she's going to have to get a court order to stop you seeing them altogether.
She wouldn't dare. Not because of one night, not one lousy night.
She said you'd done it before. She's worried about the children.
Really?
Look, I didn't ask to get involved, and I don't particularly want to.
What else did she tell you? That I'm an unfit father? That I beat my wife and kids? That's why she left?
Of course not.
Well then, keep your nose out of my business, Mrs. Jackson.
Where have you been? Ferguson and Warner are waiting to be checked out.
I know that, Vera. I don't have to be told what to do all the time.
Oh, well, I'm sorry I spoke.
Oh, it's not you.
You and Greg haven't fallen out, have you? Do you want to talk about it?
It's just my own stupid fault for trying to do the right thing.
It's not one of the women, is it?
It's two words. Jim Fletcher.
What's he done?
Nothing. Apart from being rude, aggressive, and a total pain in the neck.
Well, I tried to tell you, but you wouldn't listen to me. Now, you wait and see. He's going to cause a lot more problems before he's finished.
Ah, oh, it's good to get into something that doesn't scratch.
You look great, Moni.
Yeah, just so long as it isn't wasted on Fred.
You first, Warner. Sign there. You've checked your belongings, haven't you?
Mm-hmm. I check them again, kid. You can't trust anyone around here.
And there, for your wages.
All right, Lynn?
Yep.
Well, Vera, looks like the moment for sad goodbyes has come.
Sign there, Ferguson.
You know, you're the one screw I'd like to meet on equal ground outside this hole.
That's hardly likely, Ferguson. I don't mix with people like you.
Yeah, pity.
Now sign there.
Hey, hang on a second. What's this lousy $15? I ought to be getting 69.
There's the account. Damages to the laundry and other prison equipment have been deducted.
Now listen, I've slogged my guts out in that sweatbox for $5.75 a week and you lot have gone and ripped me off. $54, you're all crooks.
You're lucky to be getting anything after all the damage you've caused.
How are you getting to the city?
I'll catch the bus. Thanks for everything, Mrs. Jackson.
All part of the job.
No, you've done more than just that. I won't forget it.
That'll be Ferguson.
Should be easy to crack.
Right, Vera, let's take it from the top. Watch this 20.
You can read. We had to replace an iron.
That iron wasn't worth five bob.
You can argue all you like, Ferguson, but that's all you're getting and more than you deserve.